Blackstone Audio presents Bust by Ken Bruen and Jason Starr. This book is read by Peter Berkrot. For Reed Farrell Coleman, La Weinman, Sarah, and John Ruth and Jennifer Jordan, robust friends. 1. People with opinions just go around bothering one another. The Buddha. In the back of Familia Pizza on 50th and Broadway, Max Fisher was dabbing his plain slice with a napkin, trying to soak up as much grease as he could, when a man sat down diagonally across from him with a large cupful of ice. The guy looked nothing like the big, strong-looking hitman Max was expecting. He looked more like a starving greyhound. He couldn't have weighed more than 130 pounds, had a medium build, startling blue eyes, a thin scar down his right cheek, and a blur of long gray hair. And something was very weird about his mouth. It looked like someone had put broken glass in there and mangled his lips. The guy smiled, said, "You're wondering what happened to me mouth." Max knew the guy would be Irish, but he didn't think he'd be so Irish. The talking to him would be like talking to one of those Irish bartenders at that place uptown who could never understand a fucking word he was saying. He'd ask for a Bud Light, and they'd stare back at him with a dumb look, like something was wrong with the way he was talking. And he'd think, "Who's the potato eater just off the boat, pal? Me or you?" Max was about to answer, then thought, "Fuck that, I'm the boss," and asked, "Are you?" The man put a finger to his messed up lips, made the sound shh, shh, then added, "No names." He sucked on the ice, making a big production out of it, pushing his lips out with the cube so Max had to see them. Then, finally, he stuck the cube in his cheek like a chipmunk and asked, "You'll be Max." Max wondered what had happened to No Names. He was going to say something about it, but then figured this guy was just trying to play head games with him, so he just nodded. The guy leaned over, whispered, "You can call me Popeye." Before Max could say, "You mean like the cartoon character?" the guy laughed, startling Max, and then said, "Fuck, call me anything except early in the morning." Popeye smiled again, then said, "I need the money up front." Max felt better. Negotiating was his thing, and asked, "It's 8, right? I mean, isn't that what Angela—" The guy's eyes widened, and Max thought, "Fuck, the no-name rule," and was about to say sorry, when Popeye shot out his hand and grabbed Max's wrist. For such a bone-thin guy, he had a grip like steel. 10. It's 10, he hissed. Max was still scared shitless, but he was angry about the money, too. He tried to free his wrist, couldn't, but managed to say, "Hey, a deal's a deal. You can't just change the terms." He liked that, putting the skinny little Mick in his place. Finally, Popeye let go, sat back and stared at Max, sucking on the ice some more. Then, in a very low voice, he said, "You want me to kill your wife? I can do whatever the fuck I want. I own your arse, you suited prick." Max felt a jolt in his chest, thought, shit, the heart attack his fucking cardiologist told him could happen at any time. He took a sip of his Diet Pepsi, wiped his forehead, then said, "Yeah, okay, whatever. I guess we can renegotiate. 5 before and 5 after. How's that?" Bottom line, he wanted Deirdre gone. It wasn't like he could hold interviews for hitmen. Tell each candidate, "Thank you for coming in, we'll get back to you." Then Popeye reached into his leather jacket. It had a hole in the shoulder, and Max wondered, bullet hole? And took out a funny-looking green packet of cigarettes with "Major" on the front, and placed a brass Zippo on top. Max thought that the guy had to know he couldn't actually light up in a restaurant, even if it was just a shitty pizzeria. Popeye took out a cigarette. It was small and stumpy, and he ran it along his bottom lip like he was putting on lipstick. Man, this guy was weird.
Listen closely, you bollocks, he said. I'm the best there is, and that means I don't come cheap. It also means I get the whole shebang up front, and that's, let me see, tomorrow.
Max didn't like that idea, but he wanted to get the deal done, so he just nodded. Popeye put the cigarette behind his ear, sighed, then said,
Righty-ho, I want small bills at noon Thursday. You bring them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.